Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. My name is Monika and in this video I'm going to talk about blends and when they don't work. So you have seen this artwork or a tutorial and want to build a blend using text. And then you start typing the text. So I'm going to take the typeface here and let's make it larger, like so, and give it a color. And then we're going to make a copy and make this even larger. And now we also need a larger text frame in order for that to fit. And then you select the two and go to Object, Blend, and well, it doesn't work. Why is that? So the problem here is the text object. What I have done here is created an area text. So when you take the text tool and click and drag, you create area text. And blends don't work with area text. So what you need to do is make point text. Now, thankfully, this is easy. You can just double click this small widget, just double click it, and with this one as well, double click it, and then select those two and make the blend. I'm going to use the shortcut. And Illustrator creates one in between. So we are going to double click the blend tool and set it to specified steps and enter whatever we like so. And there you have the blend. The next problem is this one. So you want to create this kind of thing and there are a lot of examples using this technique. So we're going to do the same, and this should have a gradient in it. You can blend gradients and create really nice effects with them. So let's create a gradient. I'm going to take the gradient tool and want to make a nice gradient here using the freehand gradient, the freeform gradient, and there it is. And I'm going to make a copy. And let's rotate that. And then I have also already created this spine. And it has no fill, no stroke, and is an open path, which is important. And then you can select those two and go to Object, Blend, and well, again, you fail. This time it's because of the gradient. Freeform gradients don't work. So what you need is either a linear or a radial gradient, and let's take a linear gradient here and another one here, like so. And you can also rotate that, and you could also set up different colors for that. So let's just select it again and use the shortcut, and there you have it. Double click the blend tool again, set it to specified steps. And let's enter some high value, and there we have it. You can enter a higher value, and it looks like that. Let's go to the next one, which is this here. You see, there are two stars, and this looks like the stars have been rotated. So let's try that one. I'm going to make a copy of that star, and then let's rotate it and create the blend again, like so. Specified steps, 300. And well, this doesn't go as intended. So why is that? I'm going to undo it again, and yet another time. Now, this is because of the rotation. If you just rotate the object, this won't work. So what we are going to do is go to Effect, Distort and Transform, and apply the transform effect. And let's make it like so. And then you can go to the Appearance panel and then just make a duplicate and rotate it another 350 degrees. And let's go again, make the blend and double click the blend tool, specified steps, and again a high value. And there we've got this result. Because this time, what Illustrator blends is the effect. And it creates all these in-between steps with the effect applied. So that's how you solve some problems that come up when you create blends. If you liked the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.